Hello, hello, hello. Greetings in the name of Jesus. Today I'm going to be explaining Matthew chapter 2 and take home what you can get from that Matthew chapter 2. So please pay attention, and I beg of you to have patience to watch the video to the ending, because there are some ways that Matthew chapter 2 can help us in our daily living, bringing Christ to our daily living. Last week I talked about the Matthew chapter 1, and if you don't know my page, Whole Gospel Ministries, and where we pray, we do prayers, and at the same time we teach about the Word of God. And don't forget this in your daily living, that you must live holy and turn from your wicked ways, because Christ is coming soon. It's not a joke. So yeah, today I'm going to be focusing on Matthew chapter 2. In Matthew chapter 1, we find out that Matthew chapter 1 concluded by how Jesus was born by his earthly parents, of which Jesus is God, full God and full human, and to the parents of Joseph and Mary. And this one in chapter 2, I'm going to be starting from verse 1 to 6, which talked about how the news of Jesus came about, you know. So we have this set of men that study the stars. They can interpret stars. They see the future. They are trained in that aspect. How you go to university and you are trained in that aspect. So these wise men, they saw the star of Jesus far away, and because they've learned about that there is a Messiah coming, and Daniel is the one that prophesied that's the coming of Jesus. So they've read about the book of Daniel in their school, and they find out that the Messiah is going to rise. So they saw the star, and they're like, this is the star of the Messiah. This is the star of the one that we read about. So they traced this star, and they went to Bethlehem in Judah. At that time, King Herod was the king. King Herod is the king in Judah at that time. So they came to Herod and like, we saw a star of a king of the Jews. They predicted this coming of the king of the Jews long time ago by the prophets, and we have come to pay homage to this king. And Herod, being jealous because he know that his own kingdom is kind of like a fake one, there is a greater king that is coming. So he called the chief priests and the scribes, and he wanted to find out where is this king born. And they couldn't trace where Jesus is, and he called the wise men, and he told them that, please, where is this Jesus? And they said they don't even know where the Jesus is. So he told them, he said, please, in case you find this Jesus, try and come back and tell me so I can go as well and pay homage to the new king of the Jews. And so the wise men, they left and they started tracing the star until they got to where Jesus is. And take notes, and this is why I want you to pay attention. Bethlehem is the least and the smallest among the cities of Judah. But why did God choose that city? Why did God choose the smallest part of Judah for Jesus to be birth? That is why I want you to pay attention, because Jesus is the Messiah. A great king came. They didn't give birth to him in a wealthy hospital or a big place where everybody know. But they gave birth to him in a small part of Judah, least part of Judah. That's what the Bible said. But God, what I want you to pay attention is, Are you looking at yourself like, I'm the least, I don't know how to do this, I'm not the most brilliant one, I'm not intelligent? But God is saying that God is not seeing you in that direction. God is seeing you as a ruler, like the way Jesus is. So I want you to change that mentality today, that you being small, or you thinking that you are small, or you are not intelligent, that does not stop God from using you. You are a great person and you are a ruler, because the Bible said you shall be the head and not the tail. You shall be above and you shall not beneath. That's what the Bible said, you know. So try and change your thinking today, that if they can give birth to Jesus in a smaller village, according to the Bible, the least village in Judah, which is Bethlehem, your case is not the first time. So I want you to change that mentality, that God is no respecter of any human being. If God can do it in the time of Jesus, God can bring something out of you. Inside that Bethlehem, they gave birth to Jesus. So God can bring something out of you. So don't condemn yourself today. You know. So, and the Bible also said in the book of 1 Corinthians 1:27, he said, God choose the foolish things of this, foolish things of the wise. God choose the weak things of the world to shame the strong. God is even choosing you to shame the strong. So you may think that you are the least in ministry. You may think that you are the least in your class. You may think that you are the least in your family. But God is choosing you. God is choosing you today to shame the wise, to shame those that think that they are strong. It is not by might. It is not by power. It is by the Spirit of God that is inside of you. You know. So I want you to change that thinking today. Because God is taking you to places. And from verse 7 to 13, it talks about how the wise men went and saw Jesus, and they bowed to Jesus. They were so happy because they know that the prophecy is true. So they bowed to Jesus and they gave Jesus the gifts that they have. And God warned them not to go back to King Herod. So they went back home. So they went back home, and I'm going to pray for you at this time, that anyone who seek to get your information in order to harm you, God will never let them get that information in the name of Jesus. You know, so they went back to Pasha. They are from Pasha kingdom. They went back to Pasha. And from verse 13 to 15, talk about how the angel of God told Joseph and Mary to get out of Bethlehem and go to Africa, which is Egypt, that they should go and hide there, that Herod is seeking to kill Jesus. So Joseph obeyed, took Mary and Jesus Christ, and they went to Egypt. They stayed there until Herod died. And since Herod didn't see the wise men, he was very, very angry, and he gave a command that his soldiers should go to Bethlehem and kill all 2 years old children below, 2 years and below, all the maid, they should kill them. So they went and they execute all those kids and all that. But Jesus already left that city. And that is how God is going to vindicate you. Wherever they are seeking for your hurt, wherever they are seeking for your downfall, God will first of all take you from there. Because of Jesus, God will take you from that environment before any destruction will come to that environment in the name of Jesus. So they killed everybody in that. They killed all those kids. And at the end of the day, they didn't see Jesus. And after Herod died, the angel of God told Joseph to tell Mary, to take Mary and Jesus again. And they came back to the district of Galilee. And Jesus grew up in Nazareth, and they knew Jesus as Nazarene, and according to what the prophet of old said, that he's going to grow up in Nazareth and everybody's going to know him as a Nazarene, you know. So that is the whole story of Matthew chapter 2. So I want you to pay attention, that don't condemn yourself. You are God's best. God has something that he deposited in you that he's going to use to shame your enemies, to shame those that are thinking that they are wise and they are strong. May God bless you. Stay tuned. Try and follow my channel, page in Whole Gospel Ministry, where next week we're going to be discussing Matthew chapter 3. God bless you, and may God see you through in Jesus' wonderful name. Amen. Bye-bye.